Welcome students to e-Pathashala. The new course what we will be talking about the module is Anthropometry, Principles, Measurements, Applications of Anthropometry in Ergonomics and Design. Dear students, you must be wondering, what is this Anthropometry and Measurements? In nutrition-based courses, we would have used the height and weight of individuals for the BMI and other purpose. But why is she talking for a design paper about this concept? Or how this concept could be related? Let's study or understand about that. The comfort of human being to sit, stand, eat, walk freely, work without stress, you need to understand the basic anthropometric measurements, the principles and its relation to ergonomics and designing theories. The anthropometric measurements are most important data for the interior designing concepts, furniture designing and space layouts. Let's understand the objective of this module. What we be talking about here? The student should be able to understand the anthropometric principles and how it works with the measurements and the data. The next module aim could be at the relationship between the anthropometry and the ergonomics and design. And the last one, a thorough understanding of the application of anthropometry at various stages. The impact of human factors, ergonomics and anthropometry on design. A designer can use anthropometric data application of ergonomics and human factors to their advantage, or otherwise these things may work against their design ideas. Good design always observe these factors first, because no one want to use or own a product or a service which carries out the task inappropriately or with poorly or even dangerously. Consider this simple example. If a toilet is designed by a fashion designer, then the consequences of a design. As it's known that the fashion designers work to a fantasy of what the human body looks like, or they imagine looking alike. They are taught to draw human figures in a different idealized way. As you could see in the picture, it explains very clearly the two figures in the middle are typical fashion drawings, and you could see that the designs are based on these oddly proportioned unreal body shapes. Imagine on the right side the toilet, which could have been designed by a fashion designer, how the toilet will be observing. This is a imaginary body shape where a fashion designer has designed, and the same concept is applied to a typical toilet. Will you be happy to just climb up on your stepladder every time when you're going to use a toilet? Definitely not. So any designer, when the design ideas to be worked on, the problems, the space, or for that matter, even the fashion clothing, should work on the comfort of every individual or the user. Why should designers be aware of the anthropometrics and ergonomics? Designers must be aware of anthropometrics and ergonomics to ensure their ideas of any product or service is safe, and especially while designing any public spaces, they should be even more socially responsible and sensitive. The designers accommodate various majority of people, percentiles and the populations, so that the vast majority of people can get a chance to use and interact with the design products or services. So let's understand each one of the concepts. What is anthropometry? The anthropometry is the study of human body measurements on a comparative basis, and this is called as the anthropometrics. Its applicability to the design process is seen in the physical fitness or interface between the human body and the various components of interior space design. It is a measurement and study of human body dimensions like height, weight, reach. You could see the height, the reach length, etc. It is one of the most important data sets applied to fit people with their products and their physical environment. There are two ways of measuring anthropometry. One we say it as static, the other one is the dynamic. What is a static? The terminology itself says static is at one place. So the static anthropometric data is a basic set of numbered variables and brief descriptions of their use in ergonomics while the body is at still. What are static measurements? Measurements taken when a body is in a fixed state. The skeletal dimensions between the centers of joint, that is between the elbow and the wrist, the contour dimensions, skin surface and the head circumferences. The body dimensions could vary as function of the age, gender, ethnicity and nutrition, but that's not very clear. So let's look at the next part of it, the dynamic anthropometry. What is dynamic anthropometry? The dynamic anthropometric data is a basic set of numbered variables and brief description of their use in ergonomics while the body is in a moving or a position. What could be the functional dimensions? Taken when the body is engaged in some physical activity, body members' function is in concert. No systematic procedure for translating static into dynamic measurements. What is anthropometrics and design? First, let us understand the design limitations. What is the design limitations? There is a myth of designing for the average person. Since there are no people whose body dimensions are all at the 50th percentile. 50th percentile is what we call as the average. Body dimensions aren't linearly correlated, so people with short arms do not necessarily have short legs, etc. While the use of the 5th and the 95th percentile on one body dimension may exclude 10% of the population, the use of these on 13 dimensions can exclude 52% of the population. The second myth. Myth designing for the 5th or the 95th percentile. What is the 5th or the 95th percentile? Designing include to the ranges between the 5th and the 95th percentile of anthropometric data doesn't fit everyone. There are again two the misunderstandings. 5 to 95 percentile is only 90%. 5 to 95% means it's a 95% of people is only at the 90%. And if you design for 90%, you will fit 9 out of 10, that is 90 out of 100 or 900 out of 1000. The proportion keeps going on. Anthropometrics are based on population norms. Must consider differences if dealing with subpopulations such as group of Southeast Asians or offices for a pro basketball team. The next concept we'll be looking here is the use of appropriate anthropometric data. What is that? How anthropometric data are specific to certain populations which they describe. If the population is poorly specified, the percentiles may be biased. Also, percentiles are only specific to the dimensions which they describe. What is a maximum value? Maximum value examples include door clearances, door width for wheelchairs, and users' arm must work with the chair, getting a gunnery through a door and a railings. These are all the maximum clearances we talk about. The next we talk is the minimum clearances. What do you understand by a minimum clearances? The examples could include the safety clearances for railings and for elevator buttons. The next could be the design for an adjustable range. Adjustable range, again, you have to be very cautious of the cost, the benefits of including more percentile. Each consecutive percent of the population to be accommodated increases the cost of the relative to the benefits. So the employer may not give the importance for these certain things which there are no diminishing returns. So it is an essential part for the designers to convince the employers or the design functional people to look into these maximum benefits. The next could be the design age. What is a design age? How it could be worked on? One we call as the data tables. The data tables is a set anthropometric data, but it could be difficult to find and use it. There is a second one where we use a human scale. It's a series of templates are used by a computer to change the relevant attributes as the population changes. Values are printed. Unfortunately, it's still necessary to draw the figures from the data values. The next concept we use is the mannequins. Mannequins are used both by the fashion designers and the interior designers and the furniture designing people. A two-dimensional drawing or a figure which articulates the atom, which we call it as the anthropometric data applications mannequin, with plastic parts snap together like the clear movable paper dolls or the overlay transparencies. The next one we could use is the ages, the models. Three-dimensional models like the George can be useful as examples of anthropometric data. Models have often been used by clothing manufacturers. The next aid we generally use is the computer-generated models. This could be the three-dimensional models of a user at a specified percentile in certain respects. We can see the elevation plan, the perspective plan. An example is a SAMI system for aiding manufacturing man and machine interaction, and the evaluation image, which could be altered by the stimulating motion, where we could create the stimulation. But here the problem is you may not have a good data for most of the biomechanics activities. Next one, to identify the design aids, we should understand the issues of diversity. What do you mean by the issues of diversity? A wide variety of factors influence human body dimensions, including the following categories. Clinical normality in height, it's defined as about the range 54 to 79. The average stature of a worldwide for men, it's always the 64 to 96, and for women it's 60.5 or 2.95 for the generally women, or the average women we call about it. The next one is the ethnic difference. How an ethnic difference works in the design concepts. Shortest people in the world are the different pygmies, what we call them in Africa. Here the men are at the smallest, and you could see the women sizes as it's been mentioned, 2.7 and 3.07. The largest are in the southern Sudan. They are the tallest people, where you could see at a 72 inches and the women at a 66.4. So the smallest living person and the tallest living, how to give them the ethnicity or the comparison is where you are going to work at the height level. The next we could go is the sitting heights. How you could work on the sitting height of the person. Sitting height, when you reduce it with the stature differences, that gives you the sitting down positions. How you could study the entire anthropometric data while you are going to give the designs. The different ethnic groups, if you look at it, have different physical characteristics. Black Africans have proportionality, longer legs than Europeans. Eastern people have completely shorter lower limbs. This is most pronounced few Japanese and less for Chinese Koreans. That's again, you could look at the Vietnamese. However, there is some evidence that this situation is changing, and that the Japanese are also, you could see youth are little longer, having a longer legs compared to the earlier generations. So when these general rules have to be applied, how do we use these rules in the designing concepts? You could look at one as the Bergman's rule, which call as the body of size varieties increases with the decreasing mean temperature of the habitat. So what do you understand by the decreasing with the mean temperature of the habitat is based on their position of where they are living. Next they use is the Allen's rule. When we look at the body shape, how a body shape of an individual could work with the designing concept. There are three ways, we call it as mesomorph, endomorph and the ectomorph. How each style of the body shapes could understand or interfere with the anthropometric data and the principles to be formed. The next we could see the sex differences. Again in the sex differences you could see the standard differences of a men and the women. What is the dimensions of the men? How you could see that? The dimensions, men exceed women in all the linear body dimensions, where we can understand when you are going to design for the workplace, give importance if it's for a men oriented, how to design, and if it's a women oriented, how to work on it. The next is a soft tissue distribution. How the fat, the greater proportion of the body weight in women is more than the men. So when you're going to work, again, these type of concepts are very important and essential to work on it. Let's look at the next part of it, the growth and the development. How growth and development could increase or interfere with the designer's concept. One, you could see is a children. At birth average, the child weight is different from, height and the weight is different from as a child grows into an adult. So these are the concepts where you could look into it, the children, the adolescents and the grown-up adults, how the design could be work for each one of them. The age group and stature consideration, how this, as we were talking, as they grow older, the physical and the body movements keeps changing for each individual. What is actually an age group or the stature consideration relativity is, it is basically whether you are designing it for the adults or you are designing it for the children. So keep in mind how the anthropometric data could work on the height, the weight and the overall position of an individual. And the next most important concept we have to give importance while looking at the design factor is the disability. Most of the designers just forget about the disabilities. It could be the designer's fault or it could be from the designing person or the employer's way. So when you're going to give importance, always provide the wheelchair, the ramp should be given into consideration and conditions which necessitates the wheelchair use. The other one is a lower eye level at where you have to work into your conditions. If your positioning of your laptops or positioning of your almirahs, anything, you are going to look at your lower the eye level, which is the most important. The next we could look is the position of the cumbersome, awkward, space consuming. What do you mean by that? This is the most important. If your designing part is not have enough place and the vehicle or being designed in such a way, a person occupies 25 meter by 15 meter of a floor space, then where is the space for the other activities to be done? And if it's on a wheelchair, how the wheelchair is to be moved into it? The space, if he is a completely bedridden and he has to move only with the wheelchair, the size of the rooms is to be designed in such a way that the wheelchair has to be taken around everywhere. Again, the next importance we could give, the pregnancy. And the last, the most important we could talk is the time of the day. What do you mean by time of the day? At the beginning of a day, each one of us, our cartilages and our muscle tissues are at a very strong length. The power is more. And as the time comes by the evening or by night, we become extremely tired or fatigued. So these are the factors you have to consider when you are going to give importance in the principles of anthropometrics. What is the statistical treatment of anthropometric data? When you are going to design for a single person, what are the dimensions? Just give importance to each one of the dimensions of an individual. How it could be accommodated, where they could be used, how the activities are not going to interpret their basic functioning. Let's look at the understand the positioning of percentile. This percentile we had talked earlier also and we'll be discussing in few more modules. Percentile is, we were talking about the 5th and the 95th percentile. Importance of 5th is the most because 5th is the people where there are extreme conditions of a height or they could be too tall or they could be the too short. That's a condition which you are going to work into it. Next, when we are going to look at the 95th percentile of the study, the population would have some same or lesser the height. Majority when we are working on, we give importance for the 95th percentile or the 50th percentile to do the design. What do you understand by a percentile concept? It is a statistical value of a distribution. It's a very simple statistics. It talks about the 95th percentile means only 5% of the population would have this length or they'll have the proper value. When you talk about the 50th percentile, as the terminology says, it's the average. When you talk about the 25th percentile, it says only 1/4 of the population is within that range. When to opt for these percentiles? Basically, when you are designing the certain player concepts like the door height, safety hatches, etc. When you are going to use the lower percentiles, it should be the access or the reach for everyone. Door handle, the grab rails, etc. should be at the lower percentile. Always a basic thumb rule for designing is designing for the average, designing for the extremes, designing for the range. If you give importance to these three guidelines, you could work on any of the designs. What is anthropometric design guidelines? It's a very simple, I've just listed down, you could understand from that how each one of the activities has to be designed. Use anthropometric tables appropriate for population and use data. For a special clothing, add appropriate allowances. Winter jacket, it should be a little extra looser, and if it is in a swimsuit, it should be tight fit to the body. So when you're going to work on a build full scale mock-up of the equipments, facility and use it wherever you the user could use at the population level. The next is the determine the body dimensions important in design, the sitting height and the standing height, and how that basic factors, the seal to the roof, how it could be worked on if it's in automobiles. When the person is too tall, he should not have his height to, head to be get disturbed with the roof of the automobile. And even the leg length, when he is going to use his brake and the clutch, the automobile design also should be worked with the 5th and the 95th percentile. Define the population to use the equipments and facilities. Determine whether what principles should be applied, and when the relevant concepts like select of percentage of users served, whether it's a 99 or a 90% or a 95%, how you could apply it in the basic guidelines. So all these guidelines will work up if you work on the basic data details. Let's look into the next one, the steps to apply. Earlier we have just looked at the guidelines. Now let's look at the steps. How to involve these anthropometric data in the design factors. 1. Select the anthropometric measurements and you could directly relate it to the defined design. Next, you could see how these pairings determine whether the design must fit only one given percentile or it should fit the every one of them, the minimal or the maximal. You could see few examples have been given, go through it. Let's have the next concept of the step is combine all the selected design values in careful drawing, mock-up or a computer model, which we have been read earlier about the computer rates and how that could be worked out. You could plan with the modules or the mannequins and determine whether one design will fit all the users. If one could fit, yes, it's perfect. But when we say when one is fit, that is the average. And when if it is the extremes, then it becomes a 5th or the 95th percentile. How to use these steps? Select, measure, and you could see if determine the design based on the percentile and range, combine it with the certain details and compare it, then determine one of it which fit all the users and anthropometry and personal space of each individual. Few anthropometric design illustrations have been given. You could see that the first one, how the door handle must not be lower than the highest standing knuckle or the height of an individual, you could see that. The second one you could see, the width of the chair must not be narrower than the hip and breadth of the women. That's the most important. The third design, what you're looking here is, the height of the doorway must be no lower than the stature of the tall person. The fourth design you could see, her door lock must be not higher than the normal person's vertical reach. That is the most important. And next you could see is the seat heights and the depths must not exceed the maximum height and the buttock of a knee length of small persons. So far, how these anthropometric data and principles could help or work into the designer's way. So now by this time, I think you all would have understood anthropometric is not only at a nutrition level of design, it could be the most important for a interior designers and the furniture designers. And the end of this course could tell you that the importance of anthropometrics helps the individual to be more safe and free from physical discomforts and fatigue. Any products when you work on it, whether it's a space design for a commercial or a residential, need to be addressed within the limited design faults or within the design requirements. That's the most important to have a very perfect living atmosphere. होप यू कुड रिलेट दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ द एंथ्रोपोमेट्रिक विद द डिजाइन आइडियाज एंड लेट्स मीट द नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल्स एट लेटर स्टेज. थैंक यू वेरी मच.